Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. Today we will be restricting our camera movement, something I've seen done either unnecessarily complicated or not dynamic. For this one, we will not be manually placing our camera in the corners and taking notes of its position to limit its movement, but rather checking the size of the playfield to set the restrictions. I'm working in 2D, so my camera's projection is set to orthographic. Now, this isn't a tutorial on how to move your camera, but rather how to restrict the movement, but hopefully you'll gain enough knowledge to apply this to your own camera. As long as you have something moving your camera, you should be good to go. So first, let's have a look at what we have to work with in Unity, more specifically my ground object. I have a sprite renderer attached to it. What I want now is to get the size of the ground object from the sprite renderer component, and this is what sets the restrictions, or the bounds. I've also attached a box collider to the component, if you want to get the bounds from a collider. Now, create two new scripts, one called globals and one called setWorldBounds, which I will attach to my ground object here. Open up the globals class first, and let's write some code. This class doesn't have to derive from mono behavior, so go ahead and remove that here. Let's also make it static by adding the keyword static between public and class, like that. Remove the start and the update methods and type public static bounds world bounds. Open up your set world bounds class and clean it up by removing the start and the update methods. Add an awake method and type var bounds equals get component sprite rendered within angle brackets, finishing up with opening and closing parentheses dot bounds. If you want to use the bounds from the collider, you could change the sprite renderer keyword to collider2d instead. Now, all we have to do is type globals.worldBounds equals bounds, and we can access the bounds from anywhere in the project. This comes in handy when we're limiting both the player and the camera movement. Open up your camera movement script, mine being camera drag, and start off with some variables. First, we need a private variable of type bounds called cameraBounds. Then, we will also add a private variable of type vector3 called targetPosition. If you don't have a reference to the camera component, you can just type private camera main camera, and in the awake method, type main camera equals camera.main. In our start method, we can now type var height equals main camera.orthographic size, followed by var width equals height multiplied by main camera.aspect. This will give us the width and the height of the camera. Now we can type var min x equals globals.worldbounds.min.x plus width, followed by var max x equals globals.worldbounds.extends.x and subtract the width. We also need a y value, so let's type var min y equals globals.worldbounds.min.y plus height, followed by var max y equals globals.worldbounds.extends.y, and here we subtract the height. Now we can finally set the camera bounds, so type camera bounds equals new bounds, followed by camera bounds.set min max, with the first parameter being a new vector3 with min x on the x-axis, min y on the y-axis, and 0 on the z-axis. The second parameter is another new vector3 with max x on the x-axis, max y on the y-axis, and 0 on the z-axis. Now, in the late update method, where I'm setting the camera position, I just go ahead and copy this part, where I'm setting the position and set my target position to origin minus difference. So, whatever follows transform.position for you, set target position to that value. To restrict the camera movement, let's here, right under our late update method, create a new method with a vector3 as its return type. Private vector3 get camera bounds. Now, type return new vector3, and as for the x value, type mathf.clamp, and within parentheses, targetPosition.x, followed by cameraBounds.min.x and cameraBounds.max.x. For the y value, you can just copy and paste the x value, but change the three x's to y's instead, targetPosition.y, cameraBounds.min.y, and cameraBounds.max.y. And the z value can be left as transform.position.z. Now, in the late update method, we can type target position equals get camera bounds right underneath where we first set it. And finally, we can set the position of our camera by typing transform.position equals target position. Let's have a look in Unity to make sure this is working. I'll just go ahead and hit play and start dragging my camera around. It's all working, and you don't have to work with hard-coded values if you ever want to change the size of the playfield. As you can see in the scene view, the camera stops as soon as it hits the boundaries. If I were to go into my sprite renderer component here and change the size, the boundaries will have changed when I hit play. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments section. There's a link to my GitHub page down in the description where you'll find the code for this project. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.